Hey guys, you came back by. I'm glad you did. I'm Ray. This is the Happiness Factory. Today I'm going to show you how to make planter boxes for your deck or patio using these 6 foot tall fence pickets like you would use on a privacy fence in your backyard. As you can see, we have the beveled edge here from the fence. That's important. So let's measure the width of the board. So it looks like our board is sitting at 5.5 inches. Which is right here, 5.5 inches, okay? So we wanna take 5.5 inches off the tip of the board here, from here, okay? We wanna take 5.5 inches. So we wanna mark 5.5 inches down, starting at the edge, okay? So this is 5.5 inches right here. If you got a tape measure, you double check it with your ruler. Measure twice, cut once, right? So let's double check it. Yep, that's 5.5 inches. Okay, once you have all three boards cut, we'll vise them together like so. One board is your bottom board. Two other boards are your side boards, okay? Like so, okay? And the end pieces are your end boards. So we're gonna take these Jorgensen clamps and we're gonna clamp them up on both ends so they don't move. And then we'll tack it all together with some nails. Okay, we're gonna frame up this end. This goes in the middle, on the inside here, just like so. Sawdust. I'm gonna put a Jorgensen on there. Just like so. Just to hold it all together for me while I tack it up with nails. Won't fall off of there. These Jorgensen clamps are really heavy clamps. Okay, like this. So we'll just take our hammer and tap it into square where we want it. Very lightly, top and bottom. Okay. bring it back a little bit on the top. This side needs to come out a little bit. There we go. Right about there. Bottom needs to come out a little bit. Oh, too far in the middle. There we go. Okay, we'll do the same thing on this end. Take your end piece, insert it. It's a little wiggly wobbly because we don't have anything fastened yet. But we're going to take all the wiggle wobble out of it really soon. Now let's put that Jurgensen on there. There we go. We've got her clamped up. Now we can put a few nails in it. Forgot my end piece. Now we can put a few nails in it. We got to see all these uneven areas, like this sticking out. We've got to tap that down into where it goes. Everything's got to be just right. But that's okay. We'll tap it out with a hammer. That's good enough. The third piece will go in the middle of the box. The third end piece will go in the middle of the box. We're going to use some 1.5 inch finishing nails to hold it together until we decide to go a little further with it. So let's go ahead and turn it over, because we're going to nail down one side at a time. We're going to start right here at the end. You can see where everything isn't lined up. We're going to line everything up with the hammer. Just like so. And if it's gapped, if you cut a little crooked, it's okay. It's just a flower box. Everything is fine. Nothing to worry about. Doesn't have to be perfect. This isn't expert carpentry. It's just a flower box. Split on me a little bit there. Well, didn't want that to happen. It's okay. Okay, we got a problem with it splitting the wood, so we're going to have to do something a little bit different here. So I'm going to drill. I want to use screws in this, but I wanted to put a couple of nails in it just to hold it until we got to the screw part. But I guess we're going to have to go ahead and use the screwdriver, the power driver, the drill, and we're going to take the drill and we're going to screw it down. Drill some pilot holes and put screws in it, because the nail split the wood here and we don't want that. We don't want that to be happening. So I'm just going to leave that nail in there for now until I put a few pilot drill holes in here. Okay, let's put a few screws in here. little pilot hole for a screw. Got another screw gun. Let me go get it. All right, let's put a screw in there and see if that'll hold things up a little bit. Now that screw will keep it from moving. That's really good, so we need to put another one down here too. And then we'll do the other end. Let's put one right about here. And one down here to anchor the bottom. She went fast. Slow that bad boy down a little bit. That's what I want. Got to sit on one. I drove that one clean down in it. Yep. Alright, well that corner is good. I'll flip her over to the other side. There we go. Just line it up where I want it. Right about there. One right there. Wood glue on this. No, not wood glue, because this is cedar. And the wood glue is really not going to do anything for me. But these screws will hold it together. And remember, this is a planter box. It's going to be full of dirt. Now we'll turn around and get the other end. Remove that clamp in just a second. It's kind of in your way. There. But we'll go ahead and do the top. Two, and then I'll move the clamp and do the bottom. It's a little wanky. I made my cuts a little off, but it's okay. You can have that little bit of overhang. It's my planter box. It's okay. I'm not perfect. I'm not a expert carpenter by any chance. You know, you can go watch expert carpenter and do expert carpentry. That's great. These are just projects that I do, that I've learned to do over the years. And it's really cool if you live in an apartment or somewhere where you only have a little patio. You can affix this to a railing with a zip tie and have a little garden. These are great for lettuce. I grow lettuce in mine. I grow radishes. I grow red onions. Or not red onions. Green onions. And but mainly like lettuce, herbs, and I'm going to put a couple of these down my patio back here. Now they are really small, so you have to water them every day. If you don't water them every day, whatever you put in them will die. And they're good for flowers too. See, I have this driver set to 1 so it doesn't plunge through like it did on the other one. Now let's turn it over and do the other 2. Come on now. There we go. Make sure I got it. Ooh, it's capped all up really bad in here. That's okay. It's gonna be fine. That's my steel drivers are kind of old. These DeWalt's are really good. Let me see if I can hammer that a little better. Not 100% happy with the way it looks, but I'm happy enough. Smells great. I love the way cedar smells. It smells so good. It's perfect. Come on. Good. A little more. There we go. Now we can take these clamps off. Work our way down the bottom. Lighten it up a little bit. These Jurgensen clamps are nice, but they are heavy clamps. I'm telling you, they are heavy. All right. Now let's do the bottom corners. You can see I got quite the hangover there where I miscalculated my cuts, but I'm okay with it. I could probably take a saw and trim it up, but I'm really okay with it. Oh, I don't want it right there. I want it a little further back. Okay. That's where I want it, right there. These screws are going to hold it together. I'm doing a pilot hole so I don't bust any more wood. I was going to just nail it up real quick and then put screws in it. But the nails did not want to cooperate. So we price tags. These boards are $3 a piece. They used to be $1 a piece, but life changes everything. All right, let's show you now. There we go, we have her. And now, remember the centerpiece. Let's put the centerpiece in there. Right about there. Is that a good divide for it? I'd say right there is good. And I'm just going to eyeball it in place and throw a few screws to it. Da, da, da. Oh, girl, don't do me that way. Let's get you where I want you. See, right about there is the center. You can see I got it. Let me do it the other way so you can see what I'm doing. There. Make a T with it. Looks good. Let's put a screw in it so it don't move. Come on, miss. We'll find out. Holding it down with my hand here so nothing moves. It might flop when I put this screw in it, but that's okay. Just want to put it right there. That's where I want it. There we go. Tighten up a little bit more. Kind of a little flush. I'm going to trim over these. All right. Very good. Now let's put one on this side. Same deal. I'm pulling it back a little bit because it's a little crooked. One in here. All Well, I missed it completely. There we go, got it that time. All right, see, we have that in place. Now, it'll move, but we haven't put more screws in it. Now we're gonna do the bottom row. Okay, the bottom row, here's the bottom, you can see it. We're gonna put a few in there. We've gotta reach in here and push out on it. Maybe if I do it left-handed, you can see what I'm doing a little better. See the bottom right here? Now, let's see if it needs to come out any. Yeah, push it out a little bit. How about there? That's a good place for a screw. Right there. Come here, steel drill. Fortifying that bottom now. Now we put them wherever we want them, up and down the bottom edge so that it holds. And when you put the dirt in it, it doesn't fly apart. Let's put another one down here with the center board. I am getting everything under this thing. There we go. Let's put another one right there. She is. Very nice. Well, I still have this loose. So let's anchor it. Let's go ahead and put one of this to anchor it. About right here. Oh, my battery come out. I'm like, what's going on with you? Can't be dead. I just got you off the charger. Yep. Can't go anywhere now. There you go. Now, we'll just slam a few more in there. Good on that. Let's put some on this side. Down here, the bottom looks like it can come out a little bit. So we'll put one in there first, where the bow is. Where the bow is most noticeable, right there. Hold the bow out. Now again, let's do it here again like we did on the other one. Let's get this center stabilized. put a few more down this side and this side, and we'll pull that nail out of there. On a knot, move this way a little bit. On another knot. I always tell you on a knot because the drill bit doesn't want to go through. Oh, that's a knot. There's the one without the knot. There we go. Now, structurally, we are finished with the planter box. We got to do some trim work on it to make it purdy, to beautify it. Now, I'm sorry for the harsh lighting, guys, but I really wanted you to see what we were doing here. Now, we've got the box finished. As you can see, it's a nice planter box. It'll go on my patio or my deck outside. And I'm going to drill some hanging screws, holes, with a bigger drill bit than what I have, along the back in four areas. And then I will just use the same screws to screw it and fasten it to the wood of the top rail of my deck. Now, if I were going to mount it to a round pole or something like that, that we have railing or something outside of an apartment building, I would drill a large hole and run a zip tie through it and hang it with zip ties. But now let's focus on the beautification process of this box. Now for beautification, I just bought this stock. This little, what is that, inch and a quarter stock. And I'm just running along and I'll mark it with a pencil and I'll cut it to length on both ends. That's what I'll do. Where's my pencil? There it is over there. Come here, pencil. I always get under everything, don't you? All right, I've got that end marked up. I'm just gonna hold it here and pencil it like that. Oh, you didn't see that? Let me slide it where you can see it. There we go. I'm just gonna take my pencil and trim it to length. And then I'll nail it in place with those finishing nails that we had earlier. And here, and in the middle, and on the end, on both ends. Just run the laser on it, put the laser where I want it, the length. If it's gonna be too, I'd rather have it too long than too short. There we go. We'll save these pieces for later. I say you'd rather have it too long than too short, guys. Okay. Now, where's my hammer and nails? I'm just going to put one nail in it right there, right in the middle. right past the screw. I'll slide it back so I can get some force on it, okay? There, I just want to hold it. I want the nail to just hold it in place. Okay. It's a little crooked there. A little crooked. Yeah, we got us a crooked piece of wood. Oh man, that sucks. Got ourselves a crooked piece of wood. Oops, sorry about that, guys. Got ourselves a crooked piece of wood. Well, that's happened before. Just start it here. Yeah, okay, how crooked it is. Push it straight. There. Okay. Still crooked. Still crooked. Off the other end, isn't it? It's all right. We're gonna stretch her into place. Believe it or not, that's exactly what we're going to do. Ooh, right there. You're not coming off. You're going in right there. Yeah, crooked piece of wood. It's all right. We're gonna make you work. Make it work. Put another nail in it. If I can pick one up, my fingers are there. You're not going anywhere. Put you right there. Okay. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing. I'm way down here to the end. Oh, I come off the bottom. All right, we're gonna make it work. See how bowed this wood is? I have to stretch it down here. There's knots in it and everything else. Come on, there you go. Don't wanna stay. Does not want to stay. It's like, no, this is not what I want to do. But this is going to do what we want it to do, not what it wants to do. And I can look at the gap on this and say I need one. I need some more nails in it. I need a nail right here. Squeezing that gap together right here. A gap right here. I'm gonna put another nail in it over here, right by you. It's coming up over here. Oh, I don't want to do this. This does not want to be friendly. Put another one right here. And if they come out on the inside of the box, it's okay. You're going to fill it up with dirt. There. That piece of wood didn't want to do it. It's like, I don't want to be a rail. I don't want to be a rail. Now we're going to do the other side. Top side. Maybe we'll get a luck on this and it won't be all wiggly wobbly. Oh, no such luck. No such luck. Ugly as ugly is. It's all right. We'll do it anyway. La la la. They didn't cut my microphone cord, did I? All right, another short piece. Ugly old wood. See another spot there that needs attention. A little bow in the other piece. That's all right. We're going to make it work. Put one right here. Yeah, I don't want to hammer on the knot. So if I see a knot, I try to purposely go past it. Now, let's put one down here on this corner. Put a nail in here. Just to hold it in place while we wiggle wobble it around. Could you use screws? Yeah, but this is trim, so I don't want the big screw head. You know, I'm actually doing this to cover up the screws. On the show side of the box. So there we go. Right there, do it. I want you right there. Good. Let's put one on the other end. We actually could put one right in the middle, but right here on top of that screw there, see the screw, so we want to go on the other side of the screw, but I want to do the end first. You don't want to put this on the screw because it'll bend. Staples. About there, is that where I want it? That's where I want it. Put a screw, put a nail right there. Eventually, get it where I want it. Yeah, that's good. Hammer it down. Okay, now my ends are in. Let's put one in the middle. Top one's a little bit of piece of wood. A little bit of piece of wood in that bottom one. The bottom one was nasty. Nasty. Did not want to live. Said, I don't want to be a bullfrog. You ain't going to do that to me. Let's have a knot in there. Now we're going to get you back. Come on. Movie then. through. It's coming through on the inside just a little bit, but you can grind it off because you'll scratch yourself with it. It's coming through in the middle just a little bit. That's okay. Let's put one down here at this end. No, you don't. I got a little high spot right there. A little twist in it. Nail it. Nail that twist down. There we go. There she is. Now I got two pieces. See, you got two rails. Now we got three screws to cover up. Now, like I say, I do this eyeballing it because I don't want to, I know the wiggle wobble in this, that these three pieces aren't the same going across here. I know that the gap here and the gap at the other end are going to be different. So I'm going to eyeball it, cut it, and trim it. And this is where I want to use this here. Okay. Let's see what we got there. Right there. Oh, two marks. That's always good. Let's do it on this side. Turn it over. There we go. Right in there. Now, we're going to leave all this out of the way. And we're going to use this little miter box. Miter box time. We need three, so I'm gonna cut this one first. Here I got two lines, so let's split the difference. There we go, right there. And one. And then we want this one to go in this little box that we already cut right here. This is what we cut it for right here. Okay. Let's see if it fit. Well, it will. Sure will. Now we got to persuade it. Let's persuade it. We're going to persuade it into place. Covering that screw up a little bit. There we go. Persuade it back a little bit. We persuaded it too much. Right there. That's where we want it. Let's make it forever. Make it forever. There. And we just made it forever. Just persuade that back. There. Da, 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 da. What do with all them nails? Hey, right there. Okay. Now we done persuaded that into place. Let's put another nail in it. Those are screws, Raymond. What do you do with the nails? Do you eat them for breakfast? What? My nail boxes got wet. They always do. Always do. I never can keep a box of nails dry. Not ever, 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 ever. These got wet right out the parking lot. I put them in an ice chest to keep them from going everywhere and getting wet. And lo and behold to me, the ice chest had water in it. I did not know it. So, two boxes of screws and a box of nails. Yep. Now we've made it forever. That's forever. You see what we got there? We covered up them screws. Now let's cut one for the middle. Come on. We don't have to do this on both sides, just the show side. All right, since we already cut this one, and it's already pretty, we'll use this one for the two pieces. All right, where's my pencil? There she is. All right, let's see what we got there. Let's see what we got there. Covering that screw. Gotta mark it. Right there. Right there, I see it. Now, we'll just cut us another piece off of it. Where you going? Come back, yo. Don't be doing all that weirdness. There we go. Get in there. Excuse me, hammer. Oh, I accidentally saw your handle off if you hang around this block. Where's my mark? There you are. All right. We piling up over here. Piling up. We don't need any more of these wet screws. Leave them, let them dry out. Right about the middle of that mark. Right there is where I wanted it. Now we just saw this in half. It's let the block do the work. Let the saw do the work. You just supply the power, driving it back and forth. There it is. Cha-choom. There she is. All right. Now let's see what we got here. All right. Can you see? Can you see, boys and girls? Got that screw to cover up. Oh my goodness, I cut it too long. Oh no, how did I do that? Somebody wasn't paying attention, was he? And I think it's too long to massage. I don't know. Let's see. Let's see if we can massage this piece here. Didn't massage that right into place. Look at that. Is it over the screw? Well, it's even over the screw. Right there. Very good. Now we just gotta make it forever. One. Now there's a screw in here somewhere. I think we got it missed if we put it right there. Yeah, we missed that screw right there too. See what we're doing? See what we're doing? All right, now we got one more block to fill. Now at this other end, let's see what we got. Well, I'll just pull my microphone off. There we go. Let's see what we got here. What? Oh, right there. There you go. All right, we got to get this one. Yeah, same thing as before. Let's mark it up. Put a pencil. Cut us a piece off. Woo, don't go nowhere. There we go. Got a mark. That's all we need. Got us a mark on there. See that mark? Got us a mark. That's what we're shooting at. Transfer it to this side. We'll let the miter box do all the hard work. Excuse me, hammer. I don't want to mess around and cut my hammer handle off. Now let's get the miter box in frame. There we go. I got my mark in there on the saw. There we go, right there. All
go. Come on now.
Stubborn there at the end gets stubborn. Let's see if we can make it fit. All right. Oh, look at that. She fit right in there. Didn't even have to persuade it. Let's make it forever. Come on. Put some screw right there. We'll put it below that screw. Right there. Why don't you do that to me now? Had to chase that nail back in that hole. It was bending on me. Can't have none of that. There. I don't have brought enough nails, but looks like I'm one short. Walk around to the nail box and get another nail. Last nail. There we go. And here it is installed on the back deck. I just used a few screws like the ones I used to build it. And I screwed it into the back deck, three places on each side of the buckets where the dirt will go. And as you can see, we have a nice planter. I want to put one right there, which I did. I want to put another one over there, center up. And I think I can get two down that rail and one on this rail over here. And I can encircle myself with flowers when I'm out here on the deck in the summertime, or vegetables. Green onions are really good, grows lettuce really good, and it'll keep the deer and the squirrels out of my radishes, onions and lettuce. And I can put some herbs, some basil, thyme and things like that in it, and flowers. It's just a really cheap and good looking treatment that you can build yourself without a lot of tools. Now, was that perfect? No, it's not perfect, but it's nice. You know, but neither am I. I'm not a perfect person. Perfection is the pursuit of a fool. We're all flawed, and our flaws show up in our work. But that's imperfectly built for me, and I'm happy with it. And I'm going to make more of them, and I hope that you're happy. You all have value, every one of you. And this is a little thing, a few clamps. I don't know how much I've got total. Let's add it up real quick. Box of nails, let's just say $6. A box of screws, $12. Those boards were $3.25 a piece. The saw already had, so I figure I have probably less than $15 tied up in that box. And I have enough screws and nails to build the other four boxes that I want to build. I have enough wood to build one box. And so I just need to go back and buy some more wood. And then I can finish out that deck all the way around with those boxes. So, hey, thanks for watching. This is the Happiness Factory. My name is Ray, and I hope that you're happy.